President Trump delivered a stern message to Kim Jong-un during a speech in front of the South Korean parliament last night.
The weapons you are acquiring are not making you safer. They are putting your regime in grave danger. Every step you take down this dark path increases the peril you face. North Korea is not the paradise your grandfather envisioned. It is a hell that no person deserves.
The president is now in China meeting with Xi Jinping. For more on the president's Asian trip, we're joined tonight by John Sinelides, former foreign policy principal at Trilogy Advisors. Great to have you on, always.
Great to be here.
All right, the approach last night, it was historical. He laid out a roadmap of the rights, the wrongs, the moral case. I got a sense watching the speech last night in its entirety that the president did very well with the South Korean people. What do you think?
Oh, I think so. And I think it's exactly what he was looking for, to try and marshal support in South Korea, which, as you know, Ed, just recently elected a new leader who is a little bit more, I would say, open-handed towards the North Korean regime than the U.S. would like right now. We're looking for allies to gather together to send a tough message to the North Koreans that there really is very little wiggle room in terms of their nuclear program. And we're concerned about Seoul not really being on board. So Trump, I think, needs more political support from the South Korean people towards his agenda and his strategy. And I think he's moving in that direction with this speech.
Do you think it was well received?
I believe it was. I mean, I don't have any indication yet from any initial polling out of the South Korean people, but from all indications at leadership and in the media, it seems to have gone over quite well.
Did he strike the right tone?
I believe so. I mean, it seems to be a balance in terms of sending the kind of historical message that you've just described here to the North Korean regime, but also making very clear that there aren't many options for the North Koreans besides denuclearization. And it remains the only U.S. goal here. We don't know if there's another goal behind the scenes, but publicly, it's denuclearization or something bad.
Do you think this is a trip for decisions between the United States and China at this point?
Not on North Korea. I think it's still a persuasion tour. The Chinese are not ready to make the kinds of bold leaps forward to try to coalesce with the U.S. and deal with Pyongyang. That will come down the road, Ed, if we see the South Koreans accepting nuclear missiles stationed on their territory again, as was the case until the early 90s, or, worst of all for the Chinese government, if Japan decides to pursue an independent nuclear arsenal.
It just continues to build this mountain of tension across the region, no doubt about it. The response from North Korea, pretty much expected, wasn't it? Do you think this will change anything at all?
I don't think so, not right now. And as long as they have the economic lifeline coming in from China, very small trade levels, but most importantly, oil that literally lubricates the North Korean economy, and the Chinese show no sign of closing that spigot.
I mean, the president made the case, let's starve them even more. Will that work?
I don't believe so. I don't think the regime cares about what happens to their people. Several million North Koreans died in the 1990s, and the regime is doing just fine.
John Sinelides, great to have you with
us. Thanks
for having
me.
Thank you so much. You bet.